Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let me show you how to quickly and easily take screenshots on your Mac. So before I show you how to do this, I want you to go to the Apple menu and then go to System Preferences. And under there, go to Keyboard and then Keyboard Shortcuts. Then look at the list on your left and click on Screenshots. Now this will show you the keyboard shortcuts I'm going to talk about. And the reason it's important to do this is because that sometimes these can be different. Somebody could have changed them, you could have changed them. And a lot of times when I tell people how to do this, they say it's not working because simply they've changed the keyboard shortcuts. So take a look here. This is also a handy way to remember the shortcuts to go here. You can see that Shift Command 3 and Shift Command 4 are the primary commands. Shift Command 3 will capture a picture of the entire screen. Shift Command 4 will save a picture of a selected area. Now if you add the control key, then you actually copy the screen to the clipboard or copy the selected area to the clipboard. So it's important to remember that control key modifier after the Shift and Command. So I've opened up a simple Finder window so we have something to capture. And I'm going to use the simplest command, Shift Command 3. It's going to capture the entire screen and save it to the desktop, which is going to be in a file right below me there. So I'm going to move it over so you can see it. And you can see the file name says screenshot and a date and time. I can double click on it. It should open up in preview here. You can see it as a window and I can shrink it down there so you can see it a little more clearly. And it's actually a PNG file you can see there, which is a good lossless format to be able to save these screenshots. And I can use preview here to actually export it as something else if I wanted to. Now let's use the variation that saves it to the clipboard. So I'm going to add control to it. So I'm going to do control, command, shift, and 3. Going to get that same sound effect of a picture being taken, but no file is going to appear. Now I can go to an image editing program. Like I'm going to open up Pixelmator here and I'm going to create a new document. And you're going to see that the width and height of the new document fit what's in the clipboard. And then if I Command V to paste in there, you can see it'll paste in that screenshot. Now what's really handy about sending a screenshot to the clipboard is I can go into Mail here and say I'm composing a new mail message and I can paste the screenshot into my mail message there. So I can tell somebody this is what I'm seeing when I use your website or use your software and give them a message about a problem or maybe show them how to do something. You can also, of course, paste into other things like, say, Pages or Microsoft Word. So it's a really easy way to get something you see on your screen into a document that you're working on without creating an excess file that you need to get rid of later. Now if I use the other option, the Command-Shift-4, what happens is I get a little crosshair cursor here and I could quickly grab a section, release, and you can see I can get another screenshot, but this one is only of that area that I had selected. Likewise, I can go to the clipboard by using Control, Command, Shift, and 4, then grab a section. So say if I wanted to show somebody what files I had here, I can get that section right like that. Then I can switch to Mail where I'm composing an email message and paste that graphic in there. Now if you want even more functionality, you can run the Grab tool, which is in your Applications Utilities folder. And there you can capture the selection and the screen as before. But you have two different options here. One is to capture a window. So I can select that and hit Choose Window and then select that window. And I get this entire Documents window here without having to exactly select it. The other is a time screen capture, which is useful. Say if you want to capture a menu or things going on, you can set it to do a time screen capture. It'll start the timer. You can select different things like in the menu right here, and then you can see it actually when the clock finishes there, it'll capture the screen. And you can see it captured it with that menu drop down. But for most needs, all you need to do is learn those keyboard shortcuts, and it's really easy to capture a piece of your screen, paste it into an email, and send it to somebody. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.